Hello, Sweet Tooth here. I hope your day is going well. Hakuna Matata! Welcome back. Let's play some more Danganronpa! Once I get it started. Whenever it decides to start. There we go. Here we go. Ikusaba Mukuro. Mukuro Ikus. Ikusabu. That was just it. Ikusaba. What? Ikusaba Mukuro. Yeah, I can't really say it.
この学園に潜む16人目の高校生。
The 16th student lying hidden somewhere in the school.
超高校級の絶望と呼ばれる女子高校生。
The one they call the ultimate despair.
イクサバムクロに気をつけて。
Watch out for her. Kyoko told me to watch out for her. That was 3 days before the next incident. 3 days before we would be faced out with one another murder. 3 days before the worst thing so far would reveal itself. In the meantime, the day after Sakura's class trial, that morning in the dining hall, let's begin the usual post-trial investigation. Hey, you didn't make small talk or anything. You never just get straight to the point like that. If you want to keep up with me, you must refrain from pointless small talk. Jeez, how high is that horse of yours? Just acts like that to hide his own insecurities. That's what I like to think anyway. Regardless, if you want to defeat the mastermind, you need to follow my lead. They creep around the school like a how-up mouse. But the mastermind's pride is as bloated as a cow's udder. And no matter what it takes, I will rid this world of them. Hey, Tucker, you've been pretty quiet. Man, you're so boring now. You just sit there like a mushroom. Gonna start calling you Miss Mushroom. She likes it. She didn't snap back at you. Her talking makes things difficult, so I told her not to open her mouth without permission. Really? What? But if she can't open her mouth, she can't eat or drink water. I don't care. You're okay with that, Toko? Huh. Jeez, how low is that rock you're hiding under? I believe this is the small talk Byakuya warned us against. Boy. And yet, I let myself get involved. It is now finished. I will never allow you to drag me down to your level again. We're going to begin our search. Stop running your mouths and start moving your legs. Pressured by an obviously irritated Byakuya, we all started our exploration. Home sweet home! Alright, let's make our way up. I can go do my teleportation skills, but I'll just walk. Why is everybody dead here? Why? Why? This way. So here I am on the fifth floor of Hope's Peak Academy. The fifth floor is open up to us. It's totally different from all the floors we've seen up till now. For some reason, it feels unpleasant. Because it has bamboo? Huh? Does she want to talk to me about something? Tucker, what's wrong? She trying to say something? I think she's almost. Just a little more and I might get it. Sorry, but I have no idea what it is you're trying to tell me. She just let her shoulders drop. She looks so sad. I guess she gave up. Feels different compared to all the others. I'm not sure what it is. If there's some reason for that, I hope it's not anything too creepy. I don't know. We'll get to the bottom of this. What Kyoko told me yesterday. What the heck did it mean? I know, this is the fourth time you showed it. I know. No need for the flashback. Kyoko? Not gonna say anything. Huh? I can't say anything. Kyoko narrowed her eyes. Her gaze darted up to the surveillance camera. You understand why, right? You're trying to tell me whatever it was. It was important. The mastermind couldn't find out. But how did Kyoko get her hands on that information that could be that important? So finished her. She made it very clear that our conversation had come to an end. Just like usual, there were so many texts that, you know, I just had to read every single word, and it was like a 500-page novel. Because, you know, we just had to say things like over and over and over and over and over and over. We know. New information came up, and you wanted to show a flashback 4 times. Wanted to remind me 4 times. And then you want to point out the surveillance camera to make sure that the player knows, and Makoto, that you cannot say this. And then she's going to leave the conversation so that Makoto and the player do not, you know, come across the information and say it out loud so that the surveillance and the mastermind catch on. I understand. No need. No need to show all these flashbacks. No need. No need for it. Jeez Louise. God. And the suit of armor is on display. It's extremely Japanese. That's extremely racist. Even though this is totally enclosed, there's a cherry tree planted here and it's in full bloom. It's quite elegant. Is it what you consider elegant? I lived overseas for a long time, so this kind of Japanese-style scenery is refreshing. But considering our situation, isn't it kind of out of place? That target seems pretty far away, I gotta say, pretty proud of my eyesight. It's a straw post used for sword practice. Do they use it for training here too? There's a bunch of wooden lockers in here. The wooden lockers and keys remind me of super old school public bathhouses. Oh, I can look up. No matter when, no matter where, surveillance cameras are following our every move. Huh. Against the back wall, is that a pickaxe? It looks like a pickaxe. Huh, there's something carved into the handle of this pickaxe. Crazy diamond. I feel like I remember seeing that somewhere. Bags of fertilizer are piled up. There are so many different kinds to choose from. Well, Crazy Diamonds is the name of, Mongo? Mambo? His biker gang. There are different kinds of gardening tools here. Are they trying to get us to become self-sufficient? There's a lawnmower here. Even with this here, who's actually going to take care of the lawn? So many flower pots, big ones, little ones, any size you might need. Maybe I'll grow some flowers to put it in my room. First I thought I saw blue skies, but it turns out they just painted the walls and the ceiling. Oh, but the plants are all real. It's been a while since I smelled vegetation. It helps me relax. That's not what you're thinking, is it? Huh? Why is that bad? Don't you get it? Don't you realize the true horror of plant life? It's there, just beneath the surface, beneath their calm exterior. They're always watching, waiting. When they decide they can't leave us in charge of Earth anymore, they'll put their plan for global human extinction into plan. Action. I'm serious. I guess. What is this? This thing is super weird, super creepy. Flowers aren't supposed to get this big. This thing real? Watch out! That's a Monokuma flower. I came up with the name myself. Try and touch it, and you're in for some real excitement. Your heart's all like, whoa! And the plant's all like, snap. And your flesh all like, blah, I'm dead. In other words, it's a monstrosity. Pretty freaking amazing, if I do say so myself. The student at Host Peak added improvement after improvement and created this miracle creature. The ultimate botanist. Although they don't go here anymore, they died during the tragedy. By the way, despite how it looks, that flower is super practical. It can eat paper, plastic, even people. So it's totally good for the environment. Such an eco-friendly creation is vital for the future, the growth of a healthy society. Not that I know anything about that myself. Spreading more and more nonsense, Monokuma eventually disappeared. Whatever it is, better keep my distance. Is this a chicken coop? What's a chicken coop doing here? This place even has chickens, huh? They're just regular chickens, right? Like they don't eat people or lay bombs instead of eggs or something crazy like that? Seems safe. Thank you. Oh, you like chickens too, Mikoto? Yeah, I love these little guys. They're seriously cute, right? There's exactly 5 of them here. Exactly? 5, you know the number that comes after 4 and before 6? At least in terms of natural numbers. Anyway, whenever the number 5 pops up, that's a good omen. It contains the mysteries of the cosmos. It's a number of power, a refreshing number on par with hand-squeezed all-natural lemonade. Never lets me get a word in edgewise. Some kind of weird control panel set near the wall. Does it control the air conditioning or something? It's for the sprinklers. Sprinklers? Yeah, it controls the sprinklers in the garden. Sprinklers are set to go off every morning at 7:30. Don't you dare change it without permission. Of course, the setting panel is locked, so you couldn't change it if you wanted to. So that means the sprinklers go off at 7:30 every morning? Yep, you got it. Super user friendly, which just sucks. So if you get here too early, you get drenched. So watch yourself. But you're not a little kid, right? You're too old to go running through sprinklers anyway. And you have some kind of water fetish. I'm gonna tell everyone. Weird. I'm out of here. I'm so out of here. Sorry I ever went in that room. I regret it. What the hell is this? Grotesque horror of the room struck me hard and fast. What I saw was bad enough, but what I smelled, it was sour, pungent, and possibly rank. Sounds awful, doesn't it? It'd be at least be vaguely familiar to you. After all, you've been around your fair share of corpses. Are you saying? Smell of death, their flesh and fat and blood. There's no surprise in his voice, no shock. But he was right, I had experienced this smell one, more than once before. Smell of death and despair. What the heck, man? The smell here is strong, condensed. It's the smell of a battlefield. Monokuma must have. What? My fault again? They're trying to blame everything on me. If you hadn't done what you did, this never would have happened. No, it's quite the opposite. The opposite. Yep, let me give you a nitty bitty, eeky, squeegee little hint. As far as this room goes, I don't know a thing. I just left it exactly how I found it. What? How's that for a hint? Better than those stupid hints you get from NPCs and those mean old RPGs. It was pretty scary, huh? Blood all over the walls and junk? course, even in the outside world, people die bloody gruesome deaths every day. So it's not really a big deal. Just keep your chin up and keep on living, soldier. What's he talking about? Just left it the way he found it. What's the meaning of all this? Blood all over the place. I want to shut my eyes forever against such a ghastly sight. It appears all the blood stains are dry. And the color has changed as well. I think it's safe to assume these stains are considerably old. This is all really blood? Of course. I wouldn't find it interesting otherwise. And it is interesting, I assure you. What on earth happened in this room? Seems like he's enjoying himself. No way I can keep up with someone like that. There are white chalk outlines drawn all over the floor. How many bodies were there? I've seen this kind of thing on detective shows and stuff like that. You always see it at the scene of a murder. Wish I could say I don't believe it. Biakuba, what about what Monokuma just told us? Check, I'm not even here. He must be lost in thought. Is he really thinking that hard, or is he just flat out ignoring me? Probably both. Sign in the hall says Biolab. Biolab that we're forbidden from seeing into. Kinda sounds like something out of an old cheesy horror movie. I guess I've seen what there is to see up here for now. But once again, nothing I found seems to make any real sense. I need to head back to the dining hall and find out what the others turned up. One after another, everyone made their way to the dining hall. And before too long, it would appear everyone has returned. Still, it's just the six of us. It's barely enough for a decent volleyball team. Hey, don't be sourpuss. You gotta think positive. Besides, even if one person dies, we can still field a basketball team. That's like reverse positive thinking. Anyway, there's no time to be depressed. For the sake of everyone we lost, we have to do our best. Can you stop all this group hug nonsense? We need to find out what everyone discovered. I checked all the windows on the fifth floor, front to back. That used to kind of be Sakura's job, but anyway, no dice. There were metal plates on all the windows, just like everywhere else. Which means no chance of escape on the fifth floor either. But when I was looking around, I realized something about the layout of the school. What exactly did you notice about the layout of the school? You took a good look around the fifth floor yourself, didn't you, Makoto? Why? Huh? Why do you ask? Because if you did, you must have noticed the fifth floor is lacking something every other floor has. Something on all the other floors, but not on the fifth floor. Stairs. Are you talking about stairs? There aren't any stairs leading up from the fifth floor. That's what you're talking about, right? Does that mean the fifth floor is the end? Finally starting to get a clear picture of this school. All that's left now is to solve the underlying mystery. But that's the hardest part. Even if it's hard, we still gotta do it. Yeah, he is right. Everything will be okay. As long as we work together, I'm sure we'll make it out of this. No, I'm sure. We absolutely will make it out. No matter what it takes. My concern is with the biolab. That was the only place on the fifth floor that we couldn't access. Biolab, huh? Wonder what's in there. This is where, like, if this were like a cliche horror game, it'd be some kind of creature, the final boss or tyrant. We're not in a horror game, though. Either way, we don't need to worry about it at the moment. I'm bothered thinking about something that can't be understood no matter how much you think about it. Your tiny brains can only do so much. So focus on utilizing them efficiently. I really don't like how you said it, but what you said is probably right. No, how I said it is right too. By the way, did any of you find it? The other strange room on the fifth floor? Well, no. Strange is a massive understatement. Smell of flesh, and fat, and blood. The white outlines of countless corpses. More dreadful than anything I've encountered here so far. What the hell are you talking about? The smell itself was horrific, far beyond any normal murder scene. Everybody smelled concentrated. God, I'm glad I didn't see it. Feel like I'm gonna barf just hearing you describe it. Hina, you said you checked every window that was had metal plates on it. That room had metal plates too. Doesn't add up. But I mean, what the hell happened in that room? I can only think of one thing. A large group of people died right there in that room. A bunch of people were killed in there? Stop, seriously, I'm gonna throw up. Perhaps that's what was meant by the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. Huh? You're thinking the same thing then. My theory is the mass murder that took place in that room is the incident said to have happened 1 year ago. Precisely, the tragedy is another name for the genocide of the student body of Hope Speak Academy. That's true. It was when by Hope Speak was forced to close its doors. I mean, I guess that all makes sense, but it's all just so awful. Not just awful, super awfully awful. They're right. It's beyond awful. It's terrible, tragic, hopeless. But still, how is it not one of us ever? How is it not one of us? So much reading. How is it not one of us ever heard about something like that happening? Does that mean they really did cover it up? Possible. Well, there's a big garden on the fifth floor, and I found more than one weird thing to be worried about. Stupidly large plant. Monokuma said that was called a Monokuma flower. Even touching it seemed dangerous. So we have to be careful. It's totally a man-eating plant. I'm pretty sure it's different from the one that lives in the pipe, though. Anyway, that thing must benefit from the sprinkler system as much as anything else in there. Well, yeah, apparently the sprinklers come on every morning at 7:30 on the dot. Remember that. You don't want to get drenched and catch a cold. Well, you don't have to worry. They say idiots never catch cold, you know. Of course not, because idiots never get wet. I think you're thinking of ducks. I'm starting to worry about you, hero. Can you tell me what 10 plus 10 is? Hey, come on, you don't always have to call me dumb. I may have been held back 3 times, but it doesn't make me stupid. But if it'll make you happy, I'll answer your dumb question. What was the question again? Don't worry, you just answered it. Maybe Akua. Seems like Koka wants to say something. So why are you telling me? Well, because you told her to zip it or whatever. Oh, I'd forgotten about that. Jesus, man, I know you like torturing her, but come on. Well, Koka, if you want to envelop us all in your putrid breath, I won't stop you. You honor me, Master. And don't worry, I took care of the odor problem. Seriously? You're just gonna take it? Shut up and don't interrupt when Master and me are talking. Okay, so what did you want to tell us? Well, I was in a classroom on the fifth floor and something caught my attention. It was this. A knife? Well, that thing is huge. It's like Rambo size. It's a survival knife of some type. But what was it doing in a classroom? How would I know? What are you going to use that knife for? What are you planning to do to us? I'm not going to do anything. I just picked it up. I didn't want to leave a knife just laying around. I'd rather have it laying around than in the hands of a serial killer. Don't compare me to her. I'm not nothing like her. Listen, more important. Now that we have the knife, what are we going to do with it? Can't let Tessa keep it, that's for sure. We don't know what she might do. I don't want it anyway. It's way too dangerous. So what to do? Why don't you hang on to it, Makoto? Huh? Me? Oh yeah, I totally trust Makoto to take care of it. And that's that. Hold on, don't I get a say? This shows how much they trust you. You should do as they ask. Are you sure it's trust? I feel like they're just using me. Okay, so here you go, Makoto. You're acting like I already said yes. Fine. If there's nothing I can do, I'll just keep it in my desk drawer for now. Anyway, that's all I wanted to say. Hey, Toko. Ah! Do I still have breath? Made a valuable discovery. Good job. Huh? Master just praised me? Hey, good for you. That is true. There were a bunch of chickens in the chicken coop, right? That's right, five chickens. I love chickens. Let's raise them up big and fat. We can make fried chicken. Or, barbecue. Decisions, decisions. Oh, well, how about raw? Because there's nothing fresher than raw, right? Pretty sure that'd kill you. You noticed it too, huh? That pickaxe? Huh? What about the pickaxe? Well, there was a pickaxe in the tool shed, and the words Crazy Diamond had been carved into the handle. Have we seen that phrase somewhere before? It was on Mondo's uniform on the back of his jacket. His jacket said the same thing, right? Crazy Diamond. Absolutely right. Why would that be on the pickaxe in the garden? Mondo must have snuck in there and done it, right? But we didn't have access to the garden until today. But maybe Mondo brought it with him when we first came here and Monokuma confiscated. Whatever the reason, that's what stuck out to me, the tool shed, the pickaxe connecting to Mondo. Well, what stuck out to me wasn't the pickaxe at all. Huh? Then what did? What I noticed was a lawnmower. I'm thinking maybe we can use it to call for help. How are you going to call for help with a lawnmower? I don't know, maybe I can use it to make crop circles or something. Yeah, that's it. I'm going to make crop circles. You use those to call for help. What the heck's happened to you? I went like this in the beginning, you know? Well, back then my personality hadn't quite solidified yet. I didn't think it was possible, but I'm more disappointed in you now than I've ever been. Well, I think that's all the new information we have for now. So, now what do we do? Well, starting today, you're all under my command. But before we proceed, I need to figure something out. Really? Jeez, how cocky can you be? You're gonna bust through the ceiling if your head gets any bigger. So, what is it you want to figure out? Kyoko's identity. Huh? Kyoko's identity, but Kyoko is Kyoko, right? Yes, but who is she? The rest of us have a clear, definable reason for having been selected to attend Phelps Peak Academy. Hina's the ultimate swimming pro, Hiro's the ultimate clairvoyant, even Makoto is the ultimate lucky student. More unlucky than lucky these days, but... So what about Kyoko? Can anyone tell me what she is? Now that you mention it, she's never told us. Well, Kyoko doesn't really like talking about herself anyway, right? It's not a matter of what she likes or doesn't like. This is a matter of trust. Hey. Wow. That's like the first sentence that I've ever read inside this game that was actually... No, wait. Actually, like the second sentence that was grammatically incorrect. It's not a matter of what she likes or doesn't like. It's grammatically incorrect. It's not a matter of what she likes or doesn't like. Crazy. You gotta give the game props for having a great grammar inside sentences. Can you trust someone who's unwilling to reveal their true identity? You need to avoid raising any more unnecessary suspicion. So Kyoko, it's time you told us. I can't. What? Why won't you tell us? I didn't say I won't. I said I can't. What do you mean? Because I don't remember. What? I have no memory of what I am. You have no memory, you mean... Amnesia? If I thought you had a sense of humor, I'd say you were joking, but if this is a joke, I'm not laughing. Yes. Can't be serious right now, can you? I knew you wouldn't believe me. That's why I didn't say anything. But it doesn't matter. Either way, the truth will make itself clear before we're done. You have no intention of telling us. And I can no longer stand by and do nothing. What are you going to do? Torture me? Nothing so barbaric as that. I will simply limit your options. I can't allow you to engage in any further suspicious activity. Limit my options? Give me the key to your room. But if she gives you the key, room key, she can't go to sleep in her room. She'll be breaking a school regulation. And if she doesn't want that, she'll talk. It's easy. All she has to do is tell us about herself. Just hold on, a threat like that. Fine, I understand. Good, you're finally in the mood for conversation. Without saying a word, Kyoko walked right up to Byakuya and held out her room key to him. You damn fool. How do you refuse to talk? Whether I want to or not, I can't. All I can do is keep telling you that. Maybe she really didn't lose her memory. Really think about it. Doesn't sound totally impossible. The worst school ever. Alright, I think I need to take a break. The conversations are just going on and on and on and on and on and on and on. I need to take a break from all this. Anyways, I want to thank you for watching. Feel free to leave a comment. I hope you have yourself a good day, and this is Sweet Tooth signing off.